Hey, today it's time for a little test. I started with macro photography and I was thinking, do I really need such an expensive lens, or why not starting with a cheap one, with a 50 millimeter? Maybe the quality is even better. I don't know, let's find out. Okay, let's go into Lightroom and have a closer look at the quality and the sharpness of the 50 and the 90 millimeter. Let's start with that image of a small bee, which was shot with the 50 millimeter at an aperture of 9. I just want to go through a few pictures and then zoom in and have a closer look at the sharpness and the real image quality afterwards. So yeah, I brought a few images of this little insect here. And the spider, a hornet, a couple of shots of the hornet I found in the garden. Okay, let's have a closer look at the bee first. When you zoom in, I think there is a lot of detail. Maybe there could be a little bit more detail on the compound eye, but nevertheless, I think for a cheap lens, that is a really good image here. Okay, let's have a look at this little insect here. Maybe the colors, the exposure is not the best, but these images are just the raw files, so I did nothing with editing, just the raw files to give you an impression what is coming out of the camera. Yeah, I really like this picture of this very, very small spider. It's also shot with a 50 millimeters, and as you can see, you have a lot of detail, especially when you look at the eyes. Of course, there's a little bit of noise in the background. Okay, let's take a look at a few shots which were taken with the 90 millimeter. That's the hornet I found in the garden. And as you can see, there's a lot of detail when you have a closer look at the compound eye. Okay, now let's do a side-by-side comparison, having a look at the hornet shot with the 50 millimeter at f.9. Unfortunately, the ISO is a little bit too high, but to compare those two lenses, I think it's okay. When you zoom in, both lenses are able to show you a lot of detail, especially on the eye, which is quite interesting and important for me. Okay, at the end, I took a quite crazy, stupid shot of the hornet using all extension tubes I had to get as close as possible. And without cropping and zooming, you can see all the detail, but yeah, the image is just full of noise because there was not enough light. Yeah, maybe you should not take so many extension tubes and just crop it afterwards, but yeah, it was a try. Let's go back to the first picture of the bee shot with a 50 millimeter. I think the quality of the 50 millimeter is almost as good as the quality of the 90 millimeter. Of course, it has limitations. You need extension tubes, but when you start with macro photography, just go out, take one or two extension tubes. I think, yeah, they're maybe not perfect, not the sharpest quality possible, but it's a good way to start. So let me know what you think and see you at the next video.